You know what's fun about summertime? Going swimming. You know what's not so fun? Catching diseases from the germ-infested water. Hey guys, Chastity here for DNews. Summer is coming, and as temperatures warm up, many of you will be hitting the beaches or hanging out at the pool. But something dangerous lurks in those waters. I'm not talking about sharks. In the US, oceans are contaminated with oil, sewage, and storm runoff containing parasites, bacteria, and viruses. These can cause a number of diseases. According to the EPA, up to 3.5 million people become ill from contact with raw sewage sanitary sewer overflows each year. Polluted beach water-related illnesses include stomach flu, skin rashes, pink eye, respiratory infections, meningitis, and hepatitis. Legionnaire's disease can be contracted by inhaling contaminated mist or vapor. This form of pneumonia is a common waterborne infection that causes high fever, coughing, and muscle aches. Health officials recommend waiting at least 72 hours after a storm before going into the ocean. Within those 72 hours, coastal waters are polluted with runoff that may contain sewage from sewer pipes and manholes. According to a study conducted by the Santa Monica Bay Restoration Project, there is an increased risk for swimmers within 400 yards of a flowing storm drain. So watch where you swim. Surfers and divers are at a greater risk of getting sick from infested water than swimmers. Staphylococcus aureus is a common bacteria found on the human body, but a cut or a wound in the skin can open it up to a staph infection. Surfers are especially prone to staph infections and are at risk of MRSA, the more resistant strain, especially if they have wounds that are not properly treated. The results can be life-threatening. Orange County surfer Timmy Turner nearly died after a staph infection attacked his brain. Water went up his nose during a stormy day, which started off with sinusitis and an ear infection and led to something much worse. Last Christmas, former surf champion Gary Ault died from a staph infection after surfing in San Diego 2 days after a rainstorm. Swimming in lake water comes with risks too. Last summer, 70 people who swam in an Oregon lake caught norovirus, a virus that causes inflammation of the stomach and large intestine lining. More than half were children between the ages of 4 and 10. Officials believe a swimmer with norovirus infected the water with vomit or diarrhea, which the other swimmers then swallowed. Gross. While that may have been an extreme, isolated incident, lakes and streams are still in danger of pollution from sewage, livestock waste, and improperly functioning septic systems. Also, when entering the water, you should look out for blue-green algae, also known as cyanobacteria. Swimmers and water skiers may experience stomach pain, vomiting, diarrhea, or an allergic reaction after contacting water with this toxic blue-green algae. So, I've scared you off from open water, but surely swimming pools and hot tubs must be safe, right? They're chlorinated. Sorry guys, but the chlorine used to disinfect pools does not kill all germs instantly. According to the CDC, there are germs tolerant to chlorine that can take anywhere from minutes to days for chlorine to kill them. If you swallow or breathe even a little water with these germs, you can catch a recreational water illness, or RWI. The most common RWI is diarrhea. Cryptosporidium, a diarrhea-causing parasite, can survive for days in well-maintained pools. Reported crypto cases went from just over 3,000 in 2004 to 10,500 in 2008. That's an increase of over 200%. Luckily, RWI prevention is easy. Don't swallow any water, don't go into the water with open cuts or sores, and shower before and after you swim. Most of the time, swimming in a pool is safe, and it's also a total body workout and a great way to burn calories. But is it better for you than running? Trace answers that question in this video.
Running is exercise, swimming is also exercise, and they are both great in their own way, but which one is better? It's time for a science throwdown.
So have you ever gotten sick after swimming? Tell us in the comments below and subscribe for more DNews every day.